You're watching Good Day New York from the most powerful name in local news, Fox 5 News.
More questions this morning surrounding the FDNY's dispatch system following a deadly fire over the weekend in Queens. Fox 5's Catherine Gregg joining us live now from Woodside with much more. Good morning, Catherine.
Reed, good morning. What everyone can agree on is that this was a tragic fire, a tragedy that happened at this house. But there is a difference in opinion between the fire union and City Hall and how firefighters are dispatched to emergencies. The FDNY admits there was a mistake, an error in the location.
In any fire, seconds count. When fire broke out in an apartment in the Woodside section of Queens, firefighters say they were delayed in arriving because at first they were given the wrong address. A dispatcher typed 62nd Street instead of 65th, but as firefighters drove to the neighborhood, they realized where the fire actually was.
Engine 292, which is right here on 65th, did head down a few blocks and then had to loop around. They were delayed a little bit. I'm not sure the exact time.
Investigators say the building had been illegally divided. Three men died. Several others were badly hurt. The firefighters union is criticizing the dispatch system and sending out information. Leroy McGinnis of the Uniform Firefighters Association said, quote, "This is another example of a $1 billion project not working properly. Had units arrived on scene in their order, we may not have saved all the lives. However, we'll never know because we didn't get the chance." A spokesman for the mayor, however, said, quote, "The UFA is wrong. The new call-taking system had nothing to do with this tragic fire."
It took firefighters 4 minutes and 55 seconds to respond to the fire that happened at this house. The average response time in Queens to any fire is 4 minutes and 13 seconds. The FDNY says it doesn't want to speculate whether that delay would have prevented the outcome in this tragedy. Reporting live, Catherine Craig, Fox 5 News. Back to you, Lisa.
Thank you, Catherine.
You're watching New York One News all weekend.
The house fire that killed the three people in Queens yesterday is raising concerns over the city's 911 dispatch system. Flames broke out early yesterday morning in the basement of this home on 65th Street in Woodside. Fire officials say two people died in the house and one later died at Elmhurst Hospital. But the Uniformed Firefighters Association says precious response time was lost when firefighters were sent to the wrong address. Under the new unified call taker system, 911 operators dispatch firefighters directly instead of first transferring calls to the fire department. In this case, fire officials say a dispatcher entered the wrong address by mistake, sending one unit down the street and delaying it about 40 seconds. The UFA says errors are common with the new call system, and even small delays can cost lives.
Had we been on the scene, we can't swear we would have saved all lives. Mm-hmm. However, we didn't get the opportunity to. Mm-hmm. A couple minutes or more was lost in time, mm-hmm. which allowed this fire to create more heat, more smoke, and unfortunately may have led to the death of three people.
Investigators believe the fire was caused by a boiler that exploded. The buildings department says the two-family home had been illegally converted into a five-family home and issued three violations and a vacate order.
You're watching CBS 2 News in high definition.
A frantic fire rescue turned into a nightmare after three people died in a Queens home. Firefighters arrived early this morning only to find the house illegally divided into apartments. CBS's John Metaxas shows us how the aftermath has already caused a ripple effect in the neighborhood.
The early morning fire proved deadly despite the frantic efforts of firefighters to save the residents of this building. And while it's too soon to tell whether a crime was committed here, shortly after firefighters evacuated the victims, the buildings department slapped a vacate order on the premises, citing multiple violations, including an illegal apartment downstairs where victims were found.
One was right at the entrance to the front door. One was in a bedroom, appeared to be trying to get out of a basement window, was right under the window. and another one was right in the middle of the area there.
They were good, good guys. I knew them.
As neighbors mourned the victims, at least some of whom were said to be members of the local Bangladeshi community, others in this diverse neighborhood complained too many homes here have been illegally subdivided, causing dangerous conditions.
All the basement, red, yeah.
Everybody changes from two family to four and five, six families. Isn't that right? I pay my tax for two family. Why should I pay the same as they pay?
And the fire's impact already is reverberating. Just next door, inspectors found more illegal apartments and another building was ordered shut, leaving several people homeless.
I was told I had to vacate.
This man says he lived in a single room occupancy in the basement for several years.
I assumed everything was legitimate. When I was on welfare inspectors came, checked it. They were paying the rent.
Investigators will have their hands full. Perhaps most ominously, in the building with the fire, the violations included no second exit from the basement from which some of the victims might have escaped.
At this point, any role that the building violations may have had in causing the fire or preventing the victims' escape remains under investigation. In Woodside, John Metaxas, CBS 2 News.
Fire crews were delayed getting to the scene by a minute or two. The closest fire engine was initially given the wrong address, three blocks away. The Uniformed Firefighters Association says this is a clear case where the new centralized 911 dispatch system failed.
This is another example of a $1 billion project not working properly. Had units arrived on scene in their order, we may not have saved all the lives. However, we'll never know because we didn't get the chance.
Officials say the 911 operator typed in the wrong address while taking the call.
This is the PIX News at 10.
Three people also in the news tonight. Three people are dead after a house fire in Woodside. And what happened is raising serious questions about response times with the fire department. Here's Ellen Marks.
Firefighters performing CPR, working to revive one of the victims of a killer fire. A blaze that broke out just before 3 this morning in the basement of this two-story house in Woodside after unconfirmed reports that a boiler explosion set it off.
We just heard a loud bang, and that was it.
And then what?
Screaming. And then that's when we opened the window.
And you saw what?
And we saw big flames coming out of the basement.
Two men in their 30s died at the scene. A third, also in his 30s, was rushed to nearby Elmhurst Hospital, where he was later pronounced dead.
One was right at the entrance to the front door. One was in a bedroom, appeared to be trying to get out of a basement window, was right under the window. And another one was right in the middle of the area there.
Four others were injured, three of them badly burned. In their race to get to the blaze, firefighters were dispatched to the wrong location before being redirected to the right one on 65th Street, where they discovered an illegally subdivided home.
The buildings department slapped the landlord with three violations, including one for converting the two-family home into a five-family with seven additional single-room occupancies, four in the basement alone.
The fire put a spotlight on the problem, which turned out to be even bigger. The buildings department posted a vacate order on the house next door after finding similar condition.
Thought it was legal. I've been here 5 years.
Yes,
and
indeed.
Right now, I'm disabled. You know, I got no place. They just told me today I got to leave.
And then his thoughts turned to the victims, the three men from Bangladesh who had no way out of the basement inferno and no smoke detector to warn them.
They were hardworking people, and, they came to work, would go to work and so forth, and I knew them personally. And
what kind of work?
One was a security guard. It's real tragic.
In Woodside, Queens, Ellen Marks, PIX News at 10.
And the big question tonight, could those lives have been saved? Well, firefighters on the scene say it was the Universal Call Taker, or UCT, that dispatched fire engines this morning to the wrong location in Woodside, Queens, instead of 65th Street, where the fire was. Now, firefighters were sent to 62nd, critical seconds, possibly minutes lost here.
2 minutes makes a difference in a fire, and had our members been on the scene to the correct address, we might have made a difference.
The FDNY Director of Public Information tells PIX News it was human error. Jim Long says when the 911 call came in, the operator even asked the caller to confirm the location a second time. Still, he says the operator punched in the wrong street address.